Hey everybody, Mike Linville here from Black Dog Education with this week's installment of Office Hours, where we answer your questions about web design, web development, and online marketing. Now this week's question comes from Todd, and Todd writes, I've got a consulting business and I want to be able to accept payments online. What are my options? So anytime we talk about e-commerce or accepting payments online, it really boils down to two main questions that we really need to focus on. The first question is do you need a shopping cart? Because having a shopping cart and being able to accept payments online, those are like two separate things. You can absolutely accept payments without a shopping cart. Let me give you an example. Like if you've ever made a payment online for like a utility bill or a phone bill or something like that, they don't ask you a bunch of questions after the fact. They don't ask you if you want to add additional stuff to your cart. You're in, you're out, you're good to go. Okay, that's an example of a cartless payment. Now, on the other end of the spectrum with the shopping carts, if you've ever gone to something like Zappos.com or Amazon.com, you know as soon as you click on something and you say, add this to my cart, the next thing that happens is they ask you like six different questions. They ask you, well, do you want to know what other people that have bought this have purchased? Or do you want to continue browsing? Or, you know, here are some things else that you might be interested in. They're like auxiliary pieces, whatever the case may be, okay? That's an example of a full-blown shopping cart. Now, why do we want to know this? Here's the thing. As small business owners, smart development isn't overdevelopment. Smart development is actually just giving you the right tool for the right job. So in this case, shopping carts add another layer of complexity to your website. They take longer time to develop, they take additional graphical design time, and then they take ongoing maintenance, okay? So if you don't need a shopping cart, don't do it. It's just gonna end up costing you more money. Now, question number two is one of budget, right? Like most things in life, we always have options. So let's say, for example, you do not need a shopping cart. This is no shopping cart needed. You really have a couple of options. One is to go with just an online service like PayPal. That's the one that most people are comfortable with. Now with PayPal, you've got no setup fees, you've got no or very limited monthly fees depending upon which service that you choose. The big problem with PayPal is that you have to take people away from your website in order to transact the business, right? There's no branding and it's kind of a little bit of a hiccup in the process. You want it to be nice and smooth when you're asking people for money. The second option is a little more expensive, is what I consider professional payment processors. These are things like AuthorizeNet, where you can completely integrate the payment process into your website. It's completely branded. People don't have to leave your website in order to be able to transact. The problem with that is there's setup fees and there's monthly fees, and you're gonna have those fees until you stop using that service anymore. So, you know, there is that fee, that the cost of doing business with something like that. Now let's go take a look at if you want to have a shopping cart. So if you offer multiple products and you want to try to get people to buy multiple things at one time, you, again, two options here, right? The first option is with what we would consider a self-hosted shopping cart. These are things like Magento or Xcart. It's a software application, kind of like WordPress.
This just in, Black Dog Education will be giving away 9 free websites in May for WordPress's 9th birthday. Stay tuned for more details as they develop. And now, back to our regularly scheduled programming.
Kind of like WordPress that you just load onto your web server and then you can go ahead and customize it. Now the cool part is you can completely brand it, right? You can do the design work, but you've got to be able to maintain it, right? You've got a one-time fee to purchase the software, but you're gonna have to pay to get it integrated and configured. You've got to pay to have the design work done so that it integrates well with your cart. And then you've got to do the ongoing maintenance, make sure that you're all PCI compliant and all that other stuff. The second option, if you're looking for a shopping cart system, is you can go with what's called a third-party shopping cart. These would be things like OneShoppingCart.com, Infusionsoft, something like that. Now, with these guys, they're gonna be a little less branded, right? Because you're gonna end up sending somebody over to another website to take care of your business. But what's really good about these things is there's developers that are working on those things all the time. You don't have to worry about the maintenance. They usually have more functionality, right? They've got like mailing lists and all that other stuff kind of integrated. So it's really more of a rounded solution, okay? So now let's get back to Todd's question. So Todd is a consultant. So my guess is that Todd probably doesn't need a shopping cart. So without a shopping cart, that gives us two options. You can either go with something like PayPal. It's relatively inexpensive, easy to get started. Or you can go with something like AuthorizeNet. Personally, I tell my clients, if you can afford it, go with AuthorizeNet, right? Because it's a more branded solution. It makes customers feel more comfortable. You can take care of them on your website. It just looks more professional. If you can't afford it, use PayPal. At least you're getting the payments. But for me, I like to go with AuthorizeNet. I personally use AuthorizeNet myself, okay? So that's my two cents worth, Todd. I hope that this video has served you. If you like this video, make sure that you like it. Pass it around to your friends. Tell me what you think by putting some comments down below. And if you have any questions that you'd like to have answered in this type of a format, just go to our Facebook page at facebook.com/blackdogeducation, write your questions, and we'll go ahead and answer it in this kind of a format, okay? This is Mike Linville from Black Dog Education. I want to say thank you for stopping by, and we'll see you next time.